the DJI Ronin SE2 and the DJI Ronin S2.
I've been using both of these gimbals for a while now on several different occasions, and there is a couple of things that I like more with one of the gimbals than the other, and that is exactly what we're going to cover in this video.
Oh, båda gimbalerna, both of the gimbals are here.
Just gonna start out and say that if this is your first time watching me, then hi, welcome to the channel. Hope you're gonna enjoy the content, and if you do, please consider hitting that subscribe button. And the reason that I'm doing this kind of like Swedish English is because I'm kind of making a mock of myself just for the hell of it. I think it sounds fun. So first off, we're gonna talk about the DJI Ronin S2, because in my initial review, I was really impressed by this gimbal, and I still am, because it's by far one of the best gimbals that I've used. One of the things that I like the most is that it has the carbon fiber arms, but also the quick release or quick locks that you can see right here. So whenever you want to move the arms, you just move that and then lock it into place. And on the SC2, you have to turn it and then move it and then turn it back again. It's not a big downside, but it does make a little bit of a difference when you're balancing it, because it doesn't go as quickly. For example, when you're changing your camera and lens and stuff like that, it's a little bit finicky. It's gonna be a small difference. And the S2 is also extremely good when you're traveling, because if you wanna take it apart and bring it with you, it is built to be modular, and you have like the battery handle is just this small, and then the tripod is like this, and then here's the gimbal. But if you want to pack down your RS C2, then this is what you got to pack down into your camera bag, because you can't actually take it apart. You can only fold it like so, but it still takes up a lot more space than the RS2 does. But one thing that is very good with this kind of like setup is that you can go into underslung mode with the RSC2 without having to attach anything else to the gimbal. And that's something that you can't do with the RS2, because if you only go in underslung mode with this, you have to attach the separate arm that you get in the package, and then like screw that onto the gimbal and then attach the tripod to that arm, and then you can go into underslung mode. So this is a much quicker solution that allows you to go into underslung mode without having to do anything extra. I'm not a huge fan of the plasticky feeling that the RSC2 has, because it does feel a little bit more cheaper made, but it's also way cheaper than the RS2, so it's totally understandable as well. But what I would have loved is if the actual tripod was made out of metal and not made out of plastic, because it feels like this will break way sooner than if it were metal tripod. And I remember the good old days with the RS. Yeah, I think it was the DJI Ronin RS only. That included a metal tripod, so plastic, not good for an environment. Metal, better, sturdier, more reliable. Va? And the RSC2 also don't have a touchscreen, and when I was working on the Nestle commercial, I actually missed the touchscreen a whole lot, because as I was fiddling around with the different settings, I had to use the wheel. And I'm so used to using the RS2 so that I was like touching the display and like, oh. And it's actually one of the features that I think is worth stepping up to the RS2 instead of buying the RSC2. But then again, you get a lot of features packed in this for the money that you pay when you compare this to yourself. When you compare the two side by side. The touchscreen in the RS2 might look small, but it's actually more than enough to be able to do all the different settings, adjust the balance and speed of the motors. My English is not on top today. And do the auto calibration and everything that you might need to adjust in the gimbal. You don't need anything bigger than this. And you can also connect it to your smartphone app so that you can do the fine tuning and all the different like stuff that you might want to have a bigger display for. When me and Edwin was in Switzerland and when we were shooting Rivals 1, it was performing like a total champ. I don't feel that I would need another gimbal after this. As I was doing the testing of the DJI RS2, one of the things that I noticed was that this part started to like come loose for me, even though I had it locked. And I did not know that you could actually lift this up and tighten this and then make it as tight as you want it, and then it's gonna stay in place. So thank you to Horu, really good that you pointed this out. Thank you for doing that. Let's continue with the comparison. So I want to test out the stabilization of the gimbal side by side without actually holding them myself, because if I hold them with one arm, it's not going to be fair to one another. So we're going to have to create a rig, and I'm going to have to head down to the workshop for this.
So I'm thinking that we're going to make a pipe that attaches to this and then onto this as well. And we're going to attach them, weld them together here in the middle, and make a handle in the middle and some sort of plate so that I can hold both gimbals together. What do you think about that?
That's a very good idea.
I think it was this one.
Yes.
I'm more of the angle grinder kind of guy, and Dad is more of like the know-it-all kind of guy.
85. Two pieces.
Thank you, my kind sir.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I don't know what you call this in English, but in Swedish, in Göteborgska, it's a tummatre.
We're gonna have to have a plate that is 30 centimeters so we can weld that together and make our hand. That is the welding pro. I just faked it in my previous video.
Here we go. This is gonna be like the ultimate gimbal tester to see which one is actually the smoothest. Perfect.
Thank you so much for the help, Dad. Do you feel proud of this creation?
Very. I had so much work to construct this on the paper first.
Bye. See ya. Take care. Thank you.
Bye.
I don't know about you, but I actually thought that the Rone SC2 looked better than the RS2 in that test. I don't know if it's because like any kind of weird calibrations or anything like that, but we did calibrate the gimbals before starting the test. So it should be a pretty fair comparison, and we did attach them to like one single rig. I'm gonna leave that up to you, but I really hope that you enjoyed this video. And if you did, please do give it a thumbs up, because that is highly appreciated. And if you wanna see more of these kind of videos, then do drop a comment down below, because I would love to hear your thoughts on it. And, hi, Peter from, how do you say in Italiano, eh? Svezia, eh? Saying goodbye, eh?